So first of all, yesterday we have done define company and we have done define company code, right? And third step, assign company code to company. These three we have done, right? So step number four, define business area. I think business area also we have done, right? Business area. So business areas we can define, just go to say go to new entries and define business areas. Right, these three, not Sony, DRLB. So here what I'm doing, I'm going to define business area, right? Business areas, whatever we have defined, Hyderabad, Bangalore, Chennai, and even my plant area also, in order to capture the expenses, I'm defining it as a business area. So what I'm doing, go to new entries, right? So DRBN, there is Dr. D Labs, Bangalore. Right, Bangalore and DRL. So because this Bangalore belong to Dr. D Labs group. Similarly, I'm prefixing DR in front of every business area. Right, DRHY, I'm defining, right, Hyderabad, DRL. This is because the same client will be used by several people. So for that purpose, I am doing this, right? And right, DR Chennai, CH, right, Chennai, DRL. Like this, we can define any number of business areas for your
business areas. You mean the offices or the factories?
The branches wherever you have.
Okay.
The branches wherever you have, all those areas I am going to define as business areas. So four steps we have completed, first four steps. Then coming to chart of accounts, right? Define chart of accounts, assign chart of accounts to company code, define account group and define retained earnings account. These four I have to define again. Organization structure, yes, defined from enterprise structure onwards. Now, general ledger accounting, etc., I'm going to do from financial accounting, general ledger accounting, master data, GL accounts, preparations, right? These four steps, what are the four steps we have sought, right? Define chart of accounts, all these four steps we can define. Edit chart of accounts, assign chart of accounts to company code, define account group, define retained earnings account. These four steps will be, now we are defining it. But as I told you already, these things have been completed, but anyway, I'll show you how we'll do it. Edit chart of accounts list, right? We'll be going to new entries, right? New entries, DRCA, that is Dr. Reddy Labs, chart of accounts. And the chart of accounts for Dr. Reddy Labs group. Here I'm going to tell to the system, maintain language, right? Select English. English. Select English. Now length of GL account, here maximum you can use 10 digits. But what I have decided, right, for our company code, 6 digits. Right, these are the chart of accounts I have defined for my GL accounts. So 6 digits is more than sufficient for us. And if you want, you can take even 8 digit or 10 digit. But here maximum 10 digit. Right, I am telling to the system, I am going to use 6 digits. Then coming to integration. Controlling integration, that is manual creation of cost elements. These things about, we'll discuss about these things when we go to the controlling area, not now immediately. Next is group chart of account, that also we are not going to explain anything now, right? We'll discuss this later. Now only four things we have discussed. That is, one is name, that we have defined here, DRCA, and the description part, and English, and 6 digits, only these 4, right? This is sufficient. And then you have to save it, right? Because since I have already done it, I have not saved, and see, DRCA. Once you save, it will be graded out. Same chapter accounts, English 6, like this. Come back. Then assign company code to chart of accounts. So whatever our company code, to our company code, we need to tell to the system. Organization structure. So we have to tell to the system, this company code is linked to the chart of accounts. That is what we need to do now, right? Click on position, go to our DRLB, our company code DRLB, press enter. So this will be seen. Now, Agnes Dr. Reddy Labs, bulk drugs, I have to assign the chart of accounts. The chart of accounts, see whatever we have defined there, the chart of accounts is visible now. I can just assign here. So chart of account name is DRCA. Here it is available in the list. Double click on this. It'll come here, then save it, right? Now all those things are going to be saved in, say, I'm going to create already Dr. Reddy Labs request number. So this request number is going to be used for the purpose of transporting data from one landscape to another landscape, from one server to another server, or one client to another client. Right. So Dr. Reddy Lab DRL group configuration settings. I have created one request number. I have taken this. But in the beginning, you ignore this, right? Maybe because this is going to be used only to transport or to transfer the configuration settings from one client to another client. Right. I'll explain you about the landscape afterwards. Right now, Dr. Reddy Labs and the chart of accounts are linked to each other. Come back. Define account group. So define account group.
In the chartered account, you have just defined its name, right? You didn't put the list of charts.
No, now we are going to do it now. Right now I'm going to do. See here.
Okay.
Now go to new entries. Now here, chart of accounts, account group, name, from account to account. So whatever we have decided here, account group, this we can assign there. We can manually enter or simply just copy and paste. It is easy for us. First create on an Excel sheet and copy paste it. Control C. Right, because keeping this structure in view, I have created exactly the same. Right. So the PDF document, whatever I have sent you, from there you copy and paste it to in an Excel sheet. From there you can copy and paste here, right?
Okay.
Come down a little. Okay, sorry, it will not allow me now because already these things have already been defined. Like this, everything, all these things, just you copy and paste here. Right, same thing.
Instead of we doing this already repeated one, can you use a fresh server for our batch and
do not it fresh there? Server, fresh company code I can take, right? Yeah. Fresh company code I can take, but the thing is, see, now if I take one company code and afterwards again, see, only the 21 steps only we have completed. Afterwards again, you have to use same Dr. Reddy Labs only. So that's why just I'm taking this one. Otherwise, if you are not going to have any confusion, I'll take one more company code also, nothing wrong. Right. So anyhow, the same thing, whatever we have defined, cancel, yes. So whatever I do, I'll do one thing. Otherwise, I'll take, say, one sample company code I'll take for your purpose. This 20 steps I'm going to define. Right. Instead of Dr. Reddy Labs, I'll take, say, DRL I'll take. Right. So let me define even other things also. Define company, yeah. Right? Instead of DRLB, yeah. I'll define DRL. Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
I'm taking a company called DRL. Right? So this also I'm taking Dr. Reddy Labs Group. Same settings I'm taking.
No,
right,
while,
it is.
While practicing, we can take our new company and company cards. And we can
anything you can take. Yeah, practicing, yeah, I'll take other company.
So you are putting in the second line, the company name is Dr. Reddy Labs Group. So you have defined the company as the Reddy Labs Group adding a unit to it, or it's the group?
No, this is group. First, now I'm creating group. Okay. Again, I'm coming from first.
Okay.
Right? I'm coming from the first, from the beginning I'm coming. So instead of DRLB, I'm taking only DRL because for your sake, I'm creating once again.
Yeah, okay, I understood.
Right, Manoj.
Yeah.
So instead of DRLB, I'm creating only DRL because DRLB I have already created.
Okay.
Right. Instead of repeating the same thing everywhere, we'll get the same problem. Right. I'm taking this one.
Okay. Understood.
Save it. Right. Okay. Come back. Then second, define company code. So company code is the same path.
Yeah.
Double click on edit company code data. Go to new entries. And even this also I'm taking company code DRL.
Yeah. Okay.
Right. Dr. Reddy Labs. Afterwards I'll delete it because if you don't post anything, we can delete it. Right. Dr. Reddy Labs, Bulk Drugs Limited.
Yeah.
Hyderabad. INR, language English, right? Country India,
yeah.
Currency INR,
right.
English. Save it. So name, right? Just I'm taking Hyderabad, right? Just enter, that's all. Only the address part. Because for this is for the company code, it will ask for the address part. To create a new request number, what we need to do? We need to click on this one. Create a new request.
Okay.
DRL. Company code. Settings. Press enter. Right? Just enter again. First time only you create one request number, everything will be recorded in the same request. Come back.
Okay.
Right. Define business area. Right. Same business areas we can use. We have created already. Right. Nothing wrong.
Okay.
Then when coming to the assign business area, assign company code to company. Right. Assignment, financial accounting. Right, assign company code to company. Click on position. Right, DRL. Here it is DRL. Company DRL and group also DRL. Same thing, DRL group. I think it is not. Right, save it.
Yeah.
So company and company code link it to each other.
Okay.
Right. Now business areas anyhow you have seen how we have to create. Now let us come to the edit chart of accounts list. Right. Four steps. Next four steps belong to our chart of accounts. All those things. Right. The path is financial accounting, general ledger accounting, master records, general ledger accounts, preparations, revise chart of account. Here you read the theory part. It is essential to read the theory, right? It will give you very good conceptual understanding of the subject. Now, edit chart of accounts list. Click on this, define our chart of accounts. The name of the chart of accounts I am using, same, right?
DRL.
I'll say DRL only. Then this name also I am using, chart of accounts name also I am giving DRL. Chart of accounts for DRL group. Description system will not object. Right. Only this code, whatever we are going to use, only that will be objected. Right. So I can use the same thing.
So is there any limitation on the number of characters in chart of accounts? DRL, CA you can type?
Four characters here.
Okay. Only four.
4.
Okay. Okay.
Not more than that. Maintain language, English. And account number, length, 6. Right? Just save it. Then coming to assign company code to chart of accounts. Right? Now click on this. Click on position. DRL. Against DRL, I have to assign my chart of accounts name. So chart of accounts name, I have used only DRL.
Yeah.
Right? Save it.
Yeah.
So now company code and chart of accounts are linked to each other.
Right.
And for DRLB, I have the recorded version also. Right. I'll forward to both of you.
Okay.
Next, define account group. Go to new entries. And here, since I have used chart of account DRL, so let me change this. Otherwise, system will not accept. So now, right, the same thing I can copy and paste.
Okay.
Total group. So we have discussed about this group. Same thing, let me copy here. Even manually also you can enter, but okay. Better to copy onto an Excel sheet and paste here. That will be easy. So generally we, even in real time scenario, we keep this account group like this and we'll be copying paste in the projects.
Okay.
But here, here I have taken the gap of 100 numbers, say 3,01,000 to 3,01,100. But in real scenario, what I'm doing, I'm taking 1,000 numbers because the number of accounts may be more. So that's why I'll be taking 1,000 numbers there in the real scenario.
Okay.
Right? Like this, the total account group can be copied and pasted to in this table.
Okay.
Right? Come back. So that is step number 7. Now step number 8, define retained earnings account. So define retained earnings account means what is the retained earnings number. Now it will ask what is your chart of accounts. Say DRL.
Okay.
Profit and loss account statement X. X is equal to my results and surplus first number, because see, retained earnings is nothing but what? It is the profits that are retained in the business. I have to tell to the system which account I am going to use for the purpose of posting my retained earnings account. So I am going to use, right, 1,01,001, right, being because retained earnings account is part and parcel of results and surplus, right? So first number I am allotting for retained earnings. So but here I am telling to the system, right, X. X means what? X is nothing but I can prepare not one P&L account, I can prepare 2, 3, right, or any number of P&L accounts I can create. People may wonder that, you know, most of you have seen defining only one P&L account for one company, isn't it? But in real scenario, in case if it is required, you can prepare 2 profit and loss accounts for one company code, because I have certain, especially in case of funds, where there are grants are there from central government, etc., they will ask us to prepare profit and loss account and balance sheet for the separate grants. Separately they have to prepare how they are utilizing, and for that purpose certain organizations, so they will be preparing more than one P&L account. In such case, we can define X, Y, Z. If it is X, the profit is going to be stored in this account. If Y,
no,
another account.
Really, really
Z, another account.
Scenario when they have to prepare two accounts.
Hmm?
I didn't really understand the scenario in which they have to prepare.
Yeah,
two
even
accounts.
In practically
what
also.
Can be,
yeah, see, even practically, right, very rarely this scenario occurs. Right. And one more thing,
okay.
SAP has given us this provision, right? But see, the internationally you go anywhere, X is the standard statement, P&L account statement we use. If you have
okay.
more than one account, more than P&L
okay.
account, say for example, there are funds, grants are there from the central government. Grants for mm-hmm. 2 to 3 purposes they have allotted. So for
okay.
one educational organization, I have to prepare my P&L account for grants X, grant C, grant ABC are there. Management
yeah.
asked us to prepare 3 profit and loss accounts. For one
mm-hmm.
grant, how you have received funds, how you have expenditure has been made, right, the total details they want. So for that purpose, what
okay.
we can do, we can have 3 P&L accounts. So, but I am telling you, in real scenario, till now, I have done 15 projects. I have not seen in any of the commercial organizations more than one P&L account. Because
okay.
One more thing is there.
Example, what you quoted, that preparing for separate grants can be means done with the cost centers also, right?
Profit centers. That's what I'm just
yeah,
I wanted
profit.
To tell you.
Okay.
No, because of the profit centers, even this is not required. If you see,
okay.
there is a standard company code 0001 or 1000 company code. Right, in 1000 company code, if you check it, see there is a standard company code provided by SAP 1000.
Okay.
SAP IDEAS. See, here you can see P&L account statement type. See that fellow, see XYZ, right, the profit that are arriving from the, see this is unappropriated retained earnings, ER60 unappropriated retained earnings, so this is the main retained earnings in fact, see we can have 3 P&L accounts in fact, this is unappropriated retained earnings, PY means maybe previous year. ER60, so this may be some different. So for standard company code, he has used this one. Now you understand XYZ?
Yeah.
And target accounts, if profit is received from unappropriated retained earnings, will be posted here. If you are getting profit from ER60, unappropriated retained earnings, will be posted to this account. Main retained earnings, this is the main one that is going to be posted to this. So like that we can have, but I am telling you, till now I did not get an opportunity to use this practically.
Okay.
But yes, there is a facility. So it doesn't mean
okay.
that SAP has given, see one thing we need to remember that SAP has been defined keeping in view the requirements of the worldwide companies. So hence,
okay.
it doesn't mean that whatever the facility that has been given by SAP, we have to use it, right? But
okay.
if you understand what is the facility, okay, that's okay. Right, when coming to, so I am telling to the system, since I have only one account, X is going to be posted, that is retained earnings is going to be posted to this account. And once you save it, system will give you a message stating that account 100101 not created in the chart of accounts. Yes, we have not yet created this GL account at all. So we'll create when we go to the easy access screen. Once we complete all 21 settings, then we'll create this account, right? So that's why ignore
okay.
the warning, press enter.
Okay.
Don't get stopped here. Most of the students, sir, I tried to create it, system is giving a message, that's why I have not stopped here. But don't stop here, just ignore the warning and go ahead. So now 8 steps we have completed.
Mm-hmm.
Right, now 9th step is nothing but retained financial year, right, that is defined fiscal year variant, assign fiscal year variant to company code. And the notes what I have sent to you, here there is a note, I'll show you 1 minute. So here for step number 9, just I have given a note. So don't ignore that notes. Let us read it. Okay. See, from here you can just copy and paste to an Excel sheet.
Okay.
See here, step number 9. Right. Let me show you first. Close. Define fiscal year variant. So where we are going to define financial accounting and global settings, ledgers, fiscal year and posting periods, maintain fiscal year variant, right? Maintain fiscal year variant. Just go here and here you'll find a big table. T code is OB29. See OB29, right? And here I have given one note. This is critical table. Don't make any changes. Even if accidentally any changes are made, come out without saving. Right? So okay. Just I am showing you the screen. It doesn't mean that you have to do something. Right? Okay. So here I told you K4 and V3. See here. K4, calendar year, 4 special periods. I told you yesterday what is meant by, right, 4 special periods, etc. Special periods are going to be used for the purpose of finalization of accounts. And here, here calendar year is, box is checked here. Don't remove this. And at the same time, for V3, there is no check. Don't check this box. If you check this, it will become a calendar year. So April to March, 12 posting periods and 4 normal periods. Sorry, 4 special periods, 12 normal periods. And if you want to see how this has been defined, just select V3, double click on periods. So it will give you, it will show you the table. Here it takes that this is the calendar year first of all. First month, second month, third month, that is January, February, March, April, like that. Number of days in the month are given here. And so this is calendar year. Now, since ours is V3, that is April to March, this has been redefined. So redefined with, say, April first period, May second period, June third period, like that, it has been redefined. When it has been redefined, now say up to period 9, it will be falling under up to, that is, say for example, if it is a 2013, so up to 31st March 2013, that it is in the current year. And year shift is given, year shift is made as 0 here. But when coming to the January and February, March, they'll be falling under next year. In case if you are here, of course, this is general statement. This is not mentioned for which year, right? For any year, this is the same setting. And January, February, March are nothing but they'll be falling under next year. See, if you observe here, 2013, April to March, April to say December are falling under 31st December 2013, but January, February, March are falling under 2014 fiscal year, right? So that is 2014 year. So to bring them back and equate with this year, so in the year shift it has given like -1. You can understand 2014 -1 is equal to 2013. So to make uniformity of the number of months, right? So this has been defined like this. How it functions, we don't know. But in the back end, it works like same calendar, that is the financial year, that is April to March. And this April, January, February, March will be falling under the fiscal year like April to March.
So you define in February also 29 standard, or it, the system will take the actual
system
number of days in the
this
month.
Is defined by system. It is not ours. And if it is a leap year, it will take 29. If it is a non-leap year, it will take only 28.
Okay.
Right, this is standard. This is doesn't pertain to any fiscal year. Remember that.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
Come back. Right, and don't make any changes here. Don't by mistake also, even if by mistake anywhere any change has been done, just come out. Then system will ask you, shall I change the changes? Say, don't change. Why I said don't make any new entries? Right, because V3, K4, V6, all these things are standard provided by SAP. And if you create Z1, Z2, Z3 like that, I don't know what is Z1. Right, I need to explain again. Say, V3 April to March, V6 July to June, V9 October to September. Of course, every standard fiscal year variant used by different countries have already been provided by SAP system.
Okay. What is year-dependent? Year-dependent?
See, year-dependent means, say for example, of course, even year-dependent also we'll never come across. We generally you don't come across. Here, year-dependent means, right, say for shortened fiscal year. Shortened fiscal year means, say for any fiscal year, if you want to define less number of months, that is say for example, January to September only. Right, in such case, I'll define that fiscal year and I'll check it so that it will become year dependent. Because for the year 2013, my number of months are going to be only 9 months or 6 months, whatever it may be. That too, that is going to be used for the purpose of shifting from one fiscal year to another fiscal year. Recently, we got one case, one company like Wagwalls India, there's a German company. Right, all group companies are using calendar year. And India company and one other Singapore company, they are using April to March. Now management has decided to make all these things into only calendar year. And they want to redefine for Indian requirement by through special ledgers, etc. Something they plan something. But they asked us and I have given a clear note that better not to change at this juncture. It is going to be a very big project again. Change of fiscal year from one fiscal year to another fiscal year is very big project in SAP, right? You may feel that, all right, this is only small thing from K4 to V3, changing is such a project, such a big issue. Yes, it is big issue here in SAP because once we create a fiscal year, a lot of planning will be going into it. You take asset accounting, controlling, financial accounting, everywhere system plans its data. And again, removing it and again shifting it is a big job. In fact, that is an SAP consulting. SAP consulting means generally this consulting will not be accepted by any company except SAP of maybe SAP Germany or SAP India or any SAP US like that. Right? So for that purpose, when we are shifting from one fiscal year to another fiscal year, to shift, we may be defining one new fiscal year with lesser number of periods. So for that we use it. But shortened fiscal year is going to be defined with year dependent. Only year dependent means only for that particular year that number of months will be same. All other cases, say for example our V3 is not year dependent. It is year independent. That means whether whatever the year may be, the number of posting periods are going to be same, 12 periods. But in case of year dependent, for particular year 2013, I am going to define only 9 periods for this year. That is only used for the purpose of shifting from one fiscal year to another fiscal year. Right? Practically, you don't get it at all. Then, assign company code to fiscal year variant. Now, whatever the fiscal year variant that we have identified, that should be linked to our company code. See, DRL. I want to use V3 for this. Then save. Wherever gaps are there, system will ask you to fill it up. Just ignore and go out. Save it. So we have identified fiscal year and assigned here. Then posting periods. Posting period is nothing but, so define posting period variant, assign posting period variant, define open or close posting periods. So that is the period which is going to be open. say generally 99% of the cases, current period is going to be kept open. So this feature is going to be defined in three ways, three steps. So step number one, define variants for the open and posting period. Click on this, new entries. I'm going to create some variant. So I say, right, DRPV. So Dr. Reddy Labs posting period variant. So what I will do is DR posting period variant. Say I'll say DRPP. Right. So posting period variant for DRL. DRPP I have taken. Some variant I have created. I can take X, Y, Z, anything I can take. But to correlate with the name of the group or company, I am defining with the DRPP. Let us see. You will understand this after completion of third step. Now assign variant to company code. Now whatever the DRPP that I have defined, that should be linked to the company code first. Company code is DRL. DRL and DRPP. Just I'm assigning, that is linking company code and the posting period variant. Now what is DRPP that I need to define now? Then open and close posting period. Here just go to new entries. Now I'm going to define what is meant by DRPP. PP. Say DRPP. Here from period 1 of 2013 to period 12 of 2013 will be kept open. If I say 1 to 12, I am telling to the system keep all periods open, or I can say 5, 5. Then in such case only fifth period will be kept open. Then here I am taking say 13th period of 2013 to 16th period of 2013 also open. That is, these are on special period. So special periods we need not bother, but this period, this fiscal year, I need to bother whether which period is going to be kept open. Right, for the sake of some practice, we are going to do some experiments, etc. I'll take first period to 12. If this means this is going to be open, periods are open up to 12. And this rule is going to be applicable to all types of accounts. Valid for all types
periods
of accounts.
Means, periods means month.
Months. Right, valid for all account types. Right, all account type means what are the other account types? Other account types are nothing but assets, customers, vendors, materials, GL accounts, like that. Different types of accounts are there. So if I take plus, this will be applicable for all the account types.
Yeah, one query in that.
Yeah.
You said the period 1 to period 12. Is it from April to March, or it is the month, means backward and forward, means you are always on the 6th month?
See, if I take 1 to 12 means first period of 2013 to 12th period of 2013 means, okay. What is the 12th period of 2013? March December. 2014.
Okay, if you are on December, still you can post an entry in April of that month, April of that year, right?
Yeah, we can. You're right.
Okay. And if you, what you write, if it is 1-2013 and 1-2013, then what happens?
No, you tell me, yeah, which period is open? Only first period. Period is open. Only first period. That is April 2013 is open.
Okay.
If I say 1 and 2 periods are open, and if I say 3 up to first quarter periods are open.
Okay.
If I say...
So Are we going to change this every period?
Yes,
Every
you are.
month we are going to change this?
Yes, we are going to open. Every month what we do, the consulting team will be there, supporting team will be there. It is their responsibility to open the periods because, right, I think if you are working in a company, you are making every month the financial statements.
Right.
So I think one cutoff date will be taken, maybe up to 5th or 10th.
Yeah.
10th. Right. So up to 10th, say for example, now you are in the month of July. For the month of July, because now we are in month of August, right, that is not yet over. So July is already over. If I say third period means June, say imagine here third period of 2013 to third period of means June month is kept open. Once June is over, let us take July. Fourth period, July.
Yeah.
Now,
yeah.
For the month of July, I have to prepare my financial statements. But when I can do it,
right.
I'll be doing it after closing of the July only. So for that purpose, what I will do, but at the same time, my August month should be kept open. So we'll take like this up to 10th. There'll be standard instructions to the SAP's consulting team to keep the fiscal year open up to maybe 5 days or 10 days, whatever it may be, standard instructions. On the 10th day after closing of the hours, what we'll do, we'll make change.
Okay, 5 to 6.
Right. The finance department will send a mail. Right. You can close the fiscal year. We have done with my monthly finalization.
Okay.
So this is a manual job.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
Save it. Okay.
Yeah.
Then, so these are the three steps. Define posting period. How this function, we'll see. We have to post accounting entries and we'll see that.
Okay.
Right. Next, step number 14, define field status variant. So define field status variant means we have to copy the field status variant from the standard provided by SAP and assign it to
what
the company
field
code.
Field status variant?
So field status variant, we have discussed yesterday that if we are posting telephone expenses account data to bank, an accounting entry, right?
Yes.
So I want few fields optional, few field mandatory, few field suppress.
Yes.
So what to suppress, how we have to require, how to make it mandatory field, how we are going to make it optional, all those things we can decide here. How we decide, that we'll see.
Okay.
Right, this save, come back. Define field status variant. Here 0001 is the standard one.
Okay.
What is standard 0001? Let us see here. Select, double click on field status groups. Here around 41 groups are there. Group 1, group 3, group 4, group 5, 6, 7, 8, like this up to you can say 72. But some numbers will be missing in the middle. Yeah, 71 plus 1, 72. Right, but now some numbers are missing in the middle. That's why all numbers will be coming under within 41 only. So 41 groups are available. Now, let us see what is group number 1. Group 1 is nothing but general with text allocation. This will be used for the purpose of posting of some general ledger entries. If you double click here, you can see, you'll find again so many fields. All these fields you'll understand once we post an accounting entry, and I'll show you the relevant fields. And double click on general data. See here, text optional entry. Business area optional entry. But in the standard one 0001, they made it optional. But I want required entry. But don't make changes here. Let us copy this and changes will be made according to your requirement. come out. 0001 is the standard. SAP says that copy 0001 and change your name, and don't make changes in the standard settings, because standard should be kept intact. So in order to copy this one, let us select this, right, this field completely, select here, it will be yellow. Click on copy as.
Okay.
Then change the name, say DRL field status variant, for because I have already used DRFS field status, right? I'll say DRLF. DRL.
Okay.
Right, field status for, I'll say DRL.
Okay.
Press enter. Everything step by step configuration is available in the notes which I have sent it to you.
Okay.
Click on copy all, means all 41 groups I want the system to copy. So 41 groups are copied. So DRLF has been created here. Now select this, double click on field status groups. So all the groups are here in the DRLF. Double click on G001. Make what are the changes that you want. See general data. I want text required entry. Come back. I want additional account assignments. Business area required entry. Like that, whatever the fields you want to make required entry or optional entry, we can make, right? Depending upon the requirement. Because, see, business area wise, I want to generate the reports. So unless I make required entry, end users will not enter the data. Right, why I'm doing this, I'm fixing up the end user, so without entering the business area and text, he cannot save the document. So how it function, I'll show you later once we post an accounting entry. Right, so save. Similarly, business area, both the things we have done. So similarly, what we do, G005 is going to be used for the bank accounts, and G004 will be used for cost accounts and material consumption accounts. 006 is for material accounts. Like that, depending upon the nature of the account, fields are given. And all these fields are whatever the changes that are required, even that are made. Say for example, if you take G004 here, see all these cost center related fields are kept mandatory, I mean optional. So depending upon the nature of the account, we assign respective group, right? This we'll see anyhow, how we have to assign by nature, we can assign it to different types of GL accounts. When we create GL account, I'll show you. Save it, come back. So we have created one DRLF. Assign company code to field status variant. Now click on this. DRL, so DRLF, this is what we have created. Now what are the parameters that we have defined in this group? Now all will be applicable to this company code. That is my purpose. So how it works, I'll show you once we post an accounting entry. So define field status variant and assign field status variant to company code. Then coming to define document type and number ranges. So for the purpose of posting my accounting entries, I need document, right? So the document number range I need to define here. Again, here also I have given one note for step number 16. Note, make use of the standard documents provided by SAP. Don't define any new documents because all standard documents are provided by SAP. There is no necessity for us to define document types again. So financial accounting, document, financial accounting and global settings, document. We can activate, of course, T code here. So document types, OBA7 is the document, the T code, right? Define document types for interview. Execute this. Don't forget to read the documentation there. Now the standard document for GL accounting is, that is called SA. Even here I told you, we use SA for GL document. DR, DZ, DG are going to be used. So for the purpose of customer related documents. So let us first define SA. SA, let us choose SA here. Come down. SA is there. SA GL account document. Now for this I need to define number range. Double click here. And don't change this number range 01. And here you can see account types allowed. Assets, customer, vendor, material, GL account. This means with this document I can post accounting entries with reference to assets, customers, vendor, material, GL account. Everything I can use. So that is my main purpose. Now, this document type is client level, means that is high level, and any company code can use these document types. When it is reversed, system uses document type AB. Just like SA, this is another document type that also uses the same number range. Click on.
What is the reverse document type?
Reverse, if you want to say you made a mistake in posting the document. In SAP, we cannot delete a document. I think you know this. Right? Once a document or entry is posted, you cannot delete it. There is no provision for deletion of entry because for the sake of safety and security. Because say if an accountant posted a document, so my boss doesn't like me, so he has deleted the entry and he want to take me to a task, then who is going to help me? Or I myself has posted document and I want to delete it and I have deleted, right? Who's going to take care of the all these things? So that's why deletion is not at all there in SAP. Then what happens if I made a mistake? Yeah, by mistake, I have posted an entry with mistake. Means don't worry, just reverse it. So when you reverse, okay. I need not manually reverse it. I can ask the system, just click on reversal, it will reverse it. But when you reverse it, system takes the document type AB.
Okay.
And click on number range information. I'm taking my company code DRE. Here intervals display. This is status. This is creation of intervals. Click on this interval button. Then here system has asked us to create 01 number range for 2013 from number 1 to 1 lakh. So that means whatever the GL account documents I am posting, system takes 1, 2, 3, 4 up to, so 1 lakh. And it will show the current number. So every year I need to make changes. Right, every year, see 1, 2013. Again 1, 2014.
Upper limit?
This is from number to 2 number. This is upper limit.
Yeah. How do you know that it is going to be only maximum 1 lakh?
That you need to study the existing organization structure and last year how many documents they have provided, they have posted. Yes. Say if they have posted say 10,000 documents, I can take 1 lakh this year. Right, these only.
Okay. Right.
Like that, yeah. For any document type I can take around 90% higher. Right, okay. Because I can create up to 10 digits. See, okay. How many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 digits means there is 10 crores up to. So that's why I can, not 10 crores, 100 crores.
Yeah.
Right, but here I'm taking 1 lakh. Save it. Once you save, system will give you one message. So for the time being, ignore this message, because for all other things, system has generated one request number. But for number range, it generates one warning message. Right? Even that also I'll tell you, that is also related to the transportation of number ranges from one server to another server. So for this, we need to discuss about the landscape that we'll see later.
Okay.
So I've created only one document type now. One document type and number ranges. Just come out. So now step number 17. Tolerance groups for employees and assign tolerance groups to users. Tolerance group means nothing but authorization limit. Say what I'm going to do. Document tolerance groups, define tolerance groups for employees, go to new entries, say for example DRFM also I have created, so DRAM Dr. Eddie Labs Assistant Manager, DRAFM, right? So what I'm taking, Dr. Eddie Labs Assistant Manager, company code DRL, and here I'm making say 5 lakhs. So not 5 lakhs, AFM can post up to 10 lakhs, say 10. Up to 10 lakhs. System picks up the currency. Right? And so 10 lakhs. Permitted payment differences we'll see later, not now. And this is amount per account item. For accounts receivable and accounts payable, the authorization limits will be set here. And the discount can be given. So here we'll set up here. Percentage. Right. Even these two we'll see when we go to the accounts receivable section. Now save it. So DRAM. Come back. So DRAM is my tolerance group. Company is DRL. Come back. Assign user to the tolerance group. Assign user to the tolerance group means, say for example, I am logging with my user ID. What I am going to do, say my user ID Anand, and here what I will do is
DRAM.
So that will be available here. That's what I wanted to show you. See, DRAM is available. Just link here. So that now for my user ID, now I can post up to only 10 lakhs. More than 10 lakhs system will not allow me. Save it.
Means the posting, the system will not allow the posting, or system will not allow the authorization.
System will not allow me to post accounting entry if the amount is more than 10 lakhs.
Okay.
I cannot post an entry with value more than 10 lakhs.
Okay.
So like this, we'll assign the user codes for everybody. Say AO 5 lakhs, AFM 10 lakhs, FM 25 lakhs, GMF. So like this, we'll define in this table. So assign users. Now the major steps are over. Then finally, define tax procedure, assign tax procedure. This is only a formal step. I need not do this that is not required generally, because already once one tax procedure is there, that is sufficient. But anyhow, let me define one tax procedure. Right. Actually, the percentages, rates, etc. will define later. It is when we go to the accounts receivable and accounts payable. Double click on define procedures. Here just only this is a formal step. Even if you don't create, system will allow me, because already standard one tax procedure is already there. Right, just go to new entries. Say DRL tax. Tax procedure for DRL. DRL India.
Actually, tax procedure.
Yeah. Percentage of tax and everything. Yeah, this percentage is etc. We have to calculate later, not now. But here, okay, system expects one procedure to be defined for the country. With some name, okay, it has to be there. Otherwise, system will not allow me to post accounting entries for the country level. Right, that's a formally I'm defining one procedure, some procedure name, but actually the procedure we are going to define the tax percentages, so etc.
This tax is for which tax, the direct, indirect, or what one, which one?
This may be central excise, customs,
okay,
and withholding tax for all those purposes.
Okay, for all the kind of taxes.
Yeah, we are going to define that percentages. See here, tax will be defined here like this. Input tax, internal purchase tax, VAT, right, all those things are standard defined by SEBI system. Right, close this. Then assign country to calculation procedure. This is not assigned company code. So whatever the tax procedure that we have defined, that should be linked to the country. Now say country India. Against India, one tax procedure is there. Now DRL tax. So now, right, this procedure is linked to the country India. But anyhow, we have not yet defined any percentages. So that's anyhow we cannot calculate any tax now. When we go to ER and AP, we use this. Then coming to last and final step. That is define global parameters. So what is meant by define global parameters? Let us see here. Define global parameters. Here, click on this. Click on position. Go to our company code. Right, double click. Now you can see the total picture. Company code DRL. Right, country India, currency INR, Hyderabad, English, language English, chart of accounts DRL, company is DRL, right, and V3 is nothing but fiscal year variant, that is April to March, and field status variant, DRLF and DRPP. So field status variant we have used this one, and posting period variant we have used this one. So everything will be shown in one frame. Now apart from this, check this box and this box, because I want to see my financial statements by business area wise. Unless I choose this, system will not show me. And the next one is propose fiscal year. So every time when I'm posting an accounting entry, I want the system to propose the fiscal year. Every time I need not enter. System itself take it by default. Once I start posting the accounting entries. And third one, define default value date. So default value date means value date is nothing but the date on which the value is going to be affected. Say for example, I have posted an accounting entry on 20th. When I am in the, say on 26th, whatever the today's date. Right, with today's date, today I'm posting an accounting entry with posting date and document date as 20th. Now, system, how it understands is, okay, I'm posting the entry with past date, that is prior to the current date. And here posting date as well as the documented date will be taken as 20th if I'm posting like that. But there will be one field that is called default value date. That value date system will show today's date at the time of posting an accounting entry. So generally here, say this is documented date, posting date. Right. So it will take both 20th I'll take, but subsequently I'll get one more field. That field is nothing but value date. That value date field will be with current date. So though my posting date and these things are different, system will take value date, right? That is the date on which the actual value has to be affected. So generally this is going to be, it will take more importance in case of banking transactions. All right, the importance of this we'll see once we post an accounting entry. Save this. Now, as of now, all 21 steps are over. But from ECC 6 EHP 5 onwards, defining controlling area is mandatory. Without that, system will not allow you to post accounting entries, right? So after we complete this one, generally it is sufficient. Up to, if you are using the server ECC 6, EHP 4, you need not do any other things. But in from EHP 5 onwards, note, from version ECC 6 EHP 5 onwards, defining controlling area is mandatory to post any financial entries. That means we have to define one controlling area, because controlling area is nothing but the area which takes care of posting of the cost related entries. That is costing related entries, costing, profit center accounting, cost center accounting, profit center accounting and profitability analysis, right? All those things, if you want, we need to activate controlling area. So by default, in from ECC 6 EHP 5 onwards, right, controlling area has to be activated, otherwise we cannot post accounting entry. So that's why there are only small 3 sub-steps are there. We'll complete that, then we'll go ahead with the GL accounting posting. Say controlling. See, in fact, at this juncture, you may get so many doubts, right? So just patiently carry forward these doubts. Once we post an accounting entry, I'll bring you back for each and every step. The relevancy, I'll show you. So which step is working for what? Organization, maintain controlling area. Double click on maintain controlling area. Once we complete this, we'll close. Right, go to new entries. Say I'm creating, right, just only controlling area name, I'm using DRL. Name DRL CO area, controlling area. Controlling area, same as company code, cross company code, controlling it. See, generally better to select a cross company code, because when you are using multi company codes, right, there may be transactions between from one company code to another company code. So cross company code cost accounting will be taken care. And currency type, here currency type I'm using, say company code currency, so many currencies are there. Let me take company code currency, and that is nothing but INR. Chart of accounts, we have DRL chart of accounts. Then fiscal year variant, that is V3. What is the fiscal year variant we are going to use? V3. And standard hierarchy. Some standard hierarchy, that is nothing but hierarchy of cost centers, has to be defined. For that purpose we use. Anyhow, all these things we are going to study in depth when we go to the controlling area. But now just formally we are defining this controlling area for the purpose of posting my accounting entries. So I'll take DRL standard HIER. So DRL standard hierarchy, save it, say yes. System is asking, shall I create this? Then
the hierarchy, if you just give the name, it is taking. If you
use it will take. It will take. Okay. Right. So this hierarchy is nothing but cost center hierarchies, etc. See, like this will create hierarchy, right? So the name of the hierarchy on the top we use, but anyhow we'll see about hierarchy later when we go to the controlling area, right? Then double click on assignment of company codes. Assignment of company codes, don't do this first. If you are going to use this one, system will throws out. That is, it will throws to the easy access screen. And here, assignment of company codes. Click on new entries. So my company code is, so what are the company code that I have? That will be visible here. DRL. Save it. Then go to activate components. Here just only do one step. The year you give, that's all, nothing more than that. Save it. Come back. So let us stop here today, right? Tomorrow we'll post accounting entries and go further. And right, so I'll send you that recorded version to all of you.
Yeah, to me yesterday's also.
Yeah, Manoj, yeah, for you yesterday's, yeah. Also better you type your mail ID on this chat box.
Where?
Address to me here. There's below, there'll be some chat box.